Hi guys, I'm Joel. Thank you for watching this video. So, a legendary Anchorage, a new rarity has appeared, and I actually was just complaining or talking about how not having, like, just having URs don't really matter, don't really appeal to me, help me play, help motivate me to play the game and all that, and they should introduce a higher tier of cards, and they actually did introduce that. Funny enough, although people have been talking about getting this higher tier of cards since 2014, if you can believe it. So it's quite a while, and then finally we get it. So this is the first ever LR card, Wise Oracle, and then they are very, 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 very generous with the card. You can see here that you can see, first off, the art is extremely good. Very, very good. I'd say, you know, what do you call that? Legendary Anchorage level, at least the earlier ones, not the current one. That tree is pretty ugly. Not as good as the others, at least, in my opinion. And Wise Oracle is very, very good. Okay, and Oracle also fits the main character of this game, I guess, which is Oracle. She's everywhere, and okay, so Wise Oracle, you can get look at her skills. There's Valkyrie Rod, don't know where she sticks it in, but what she sticks it in, not where, but she unleashes a single ally skill. That's why I said where she sticks it in. I mean, I guess you don't have to do that. You could do that kind of waving action and then unleash, right? You don't have to actually poke your ally. That would be painful for a skill activation. Anyway, so 5 activations unseen before, and then unleash ally skill at 30%, also high, unseen before. So obviously this is the that was the HLR, then now it's normal LR, and you can see the skill don't really change. And then you get skill notification, 5 activations and 60% chance, and then once again they don't really change after changing in the HLR. So I'm quite interested in looking at the GLR version, and let's have a look if it is in the Awakened box. Okay, so this card is crazy. Okay, it's crazy good. I don't know how good it is in terms of, okay, I guess they don't have that yet, and how good it is in terms of fighting, in terms of battle, right? So but I mean, can she really easily take out a legendary Anchorage? I'm just thinking that. And I guess she's as good as two like proper GUR cards. I mean, in terms of usefulness, you get her, you get she's basically Unleasher and Skill Nullifier all in one, and then she's also an attacker. Okay, so I guess you still need a buffer. The setup would still be for 3 Unleashers, 1 buffer, and then a Wise Oracle, although you would definitely continue using Wise Oracle. But then, is she subject to the damage cap, right? If she is, then she's not that useful. I mean, she is very useful, but not that useful and all that. So I don't know. You look at the stats, and then it's effing great, you know, great AF. But then you think about it. Did they say anywhere that I don't think they did. I had a read, actually. And anyway, so I had a look, and then they didn't really say whether she can bypass the maximum attack limit. If she doesn't, then she's basically a card that doesn't require so many buffs to reach the limit. So I guess that's something, but is that worth throwing your money at? I am not sure, although some people definitely will, although I have not seen anybody successful yet. So I've been quite curious, and I've been logging on and looking at this kind of commemorative summon list of lucky people. I haven't seen anything yet. So, talking about how much money you need, or how many jewels you need, okay, because I don't know which region you're in, how much jewels you buy and all that. So how many jewels do you need? So look at the summon rates, and then immediately you can see it's 0.002%, which is, like, why would you do that to yourself? Look at, that means on an expected value basis, okay, it's 50,000, draws. Okay, 50,000 draws, it's 5,000 summons, right? The jewel summons. This is crazy. Why anyone would throw that kind of money at a card like this that I've just analyzed, that maybe she's still subject to the damage ceiling, and I don't know why you would, if she's not that useful, when if that is the case. And yeah, so you would need to throw a lot of money there, and that's just the expected value, right? If you want to be a bit more serious about it, okay, you gotta consider the mathematics. Okay, so this might be a bit dark, I guess, but never mind, just bear with me. So what's gonna happen is you get 99.998%, right? So that's the probability of not getting it. Okay, P naught is equal to that, right? And to like every draw. Okay, so suppose you do N draws, right? Then it's actually the probability of not getting her is 99% to the power of N, right? Like that, or if you prefer, you can put a bracket on it, okay? Right, so that's the probability of not getting her. Right, so what's the probability of getting at least one copy of her in N draws? Right, so that means it's just that. Easy. Right? Easy. And what you want to do is, suppose I want to get her kind of for sure. Right? So this is the tricky part, or the judgmental, the part that requires judgment. Okay, so what exactly is certain? Well, I consider certain, for example, when you consider critical levels or significance levels, it's normally 5%, right? So I wanna get her for sure for at 95%, like sure, right? I want the probability of getting her to be 95%. It's pretty much it will happen, right? Unless you're really unlucky, I guess. So you get this formula, and then what do? You just flip it around, and then what you get is this. Okay, easy joke. Easy, and then N equals to 5%, okay? Because you it's easy, you take the one over here, and then you cancel out the negative, and then you get this. And then so N equals to, I'm just skipping ahead over here, 5 divided by this. Okay, and where does that take us? Let me look at the calculator. And anyway, suppose you do the maths, and then it's basically 150,000, which is crazy, 150,000 draws. But although actually in reality, the number of draws is a lot lower, because there is also this thing where they give you a kind of slot machine, and then if you're ultra fever, then you get... Okay, suppose you reach Ultra Fever, let's call it UF, then you get HSR, and then HUR, and then you get the LR. Okay, so this really throws a spanner into the works, because you don't know, I guess, I did try it last time they introduced this fever thing, and then basically, it seems to be that, okay, I have to... say that I have not tried it this time, but the system might not be what it was like last time, because I can't really confirm it. So what happens is that you do one draw, right? And after that it's fever, and then you do another draw, and after that it's I think it's high fever or something like that, right? And then anyway, so you reach that point where you for this time there's a... Is it really Ultimate Fever? I don't know. I don't really remember. But you know what I mean. It's either Ultimate Fever or it's High Fever. And then you get a chance of getting HSR, H1, or LR, right? So this is also a very... It looks better. It is better, but how much better? It really depends on how they do this thing. Okay, so you get these three, right? So do they do a weighted average, or do they have a very simple, like, you have fever, right, And then you have a chance of getting either of these, right? So it's so the probability is like a third, and a third. Now, if that is the case, then it is okay. It's it dramatically increases your drop rate, although still extremely low. It really increases your drop rate, and then you can go on to calculate how much you get. Yeah. But what if they do this? What if they do a weighted average? Now, you would be just as screwed as you were before. Right? Not just as, but you'd be a bit better. But what is a weighted average? So what they could do is they could do this. Okay, so R is 0.02%, right? And then what's a UR, okay? I'm just assuming that they give you a UR card and then they turn it into a HUR card. Okay, that's what they do. So a weighted average would be the sum of the probability of all UR cards. Okay, and then similarly, this would be the sum of the probability of all SR cards. Okay, now that is the weighted average. The weighted thing. Okay, let's do that. Okay, so I actually took the time, although I'm quite sleepy, to actually calculate the weighted probability. So what do you mean I weighted is that? So what are the UR card? So what is this? What are these numbers? So the UR card is basically has one UR card that's like this, that's 0.11%, okay? And then there are 8 pages, each page has 16, and each UR has 0.003% probability. And you also need to add, because there's one page that has, I think, 4 URs, but you add the 4, but you take out the LR, and then the entries, it's just counting, okay? Hey, and then you get this. So, okay, so there's a 0.5% probability of getting UR. And then the same consideration goes for SR cards. There are 13 pages of SRs, and then you add the SRs that have extra chance, and then you take out the entries that, you know, that because this just one of the pages isn't a whole page of SRs. And anyway, you get 6.338, okay, 0.5. And then this is LR, 0.02%, all right? And then all, you weight them, what does weighting them mean? It's just 0.02 times 6.338, okay? Plus 0.5 plus 0.002, okay? So we just do that, and then that's a weighted probability, weighted, and then you get this. And then you get this. 0.03%. Okay, it's not even 0.03, 0.029%. Okay, so it's almost midnight and I'm about to turn off my brain, but anyway, so what this means is that they could have a probability of 0.029% per fever, or it could be this. They're very lenient, and then they give you this this probability. Okay. So after all that calculation and during, like, I'm very sleepy and hungry. And then, so, is the LR worth it at the end of the day? I mean, it's just the probability is so low. And, okay, you know what, by the way, let's go and have a look at what the fever is like. Okay? What the fever is like. I forgot. I think there are 2 tiers of fever. Right. So you get a fever, and then you get super fever, and then you get ultra fever. So my, memory has not failed me, okay? I don't think they can give you, well, I guess they can, I can't really say for them, but if you consider the summon rate of the LR, like on its own, the vanilla summon rate at 0.002%, what's the chance that they'll give you a 33.333% chance of getting the LR once you hit Ultra Fever? And if that is the case, I'm thinking we would see a lot more people getting the LRs. Okay, so just my conjecture, just my calculations and my guesses, okay? So it's gonna be a hard route, okay? It's gonna be the hard route. That means you're gonna need thousands of summons And again, I'm pretty sure someone will be able to get it and propose a video of it and probably debunk, okay, debunk my calculations or confirm my calculations or anything. So that's something to look forward to. But anyway, I'm extremely sleepy and I should go to bed. And thanks very much for watching. And once again, you know, if, I don't know, it depends on how rich you are, but unless you're really, really rich, then don't spend this kind of money on a game like this, to be honest. Anyway, I digress, and I'm sleepy, so that's it for my video. Thank you very much for watching. Unless you're rich, don't try for LR. And also, they might just introduce a free LR down the line, like in Christmas or something, right? And then you're looking at your Wise Oracle that you spent thousands on, and you're like, dude, I shouldn't have done that. Anyway, sleepy, goodbye, good night.